Because history is just, it's so relevant, it's so personal, it means something to everybody, and it doesn't matter how long you study history for, you talk about it in a different way. The way that the girls respond and react to it will always be different because they are looking at it through their own personal lens. It also it helps pupils to really become quite critical in their thinking. It builds their confidence. I do think it builds resilience. It gives them opportunities to challenge, but in quite an informed way. I teach history across the three-year curriculum at Key Stage 3, from the ancient world to the modern era. And there's a very strong focus, not just on British history, but also on European and world history. So pupils can expect to learn, say in year seven, there's an element of skills-based learning that is set in the ancient world. So it's kind of taught as an introduction to, you know, what we as historians build in terms of our skills, how we approach it, working with evidence, working with interpretations. In the second year, for example, year eights may move forward in time to the early modern period into the industrial. And that would be more of a focus on studying migration, studying empires and decolonization with more of a world focus. In year nine, we push into the last 100 years, so it's a modern study. Some of the big concepts that we explore are the politics of the last 100 years, because politics has become quite extreme. And that's certainly something that by year nine, broaching GCSE study, pupils are trying to make more sense of their place in the world. They're trying to make sense of those big stories that they read on social media or in the newspapers. And so much of that does link to, you know, our sort of political ideas and other people's political ideas. And now more than ever, I think history really does have a place to explore those.